Let's start with lateral meristem now. As the name suggests, this lateral meristem is present towards lateral sides of the plant organs like stem and root. So it is called as lateral meristem. Let's see where it is present. So let's say this is the shoot. This is the shoot. And this is shoot apical meristem. So we already know that this is shoot apical meristem. And this is intercalary meristem. And now this is lateral meristem, like this, which is present towards lateral sides. This is called lateral meristem. So this is lateral meristem. Okay, so on the basis of origin, this lateral meristem is of two types. They are primary lateral meristem and secondary lateral meristem. So this lateral meristem is of two types on the basis of origin. They are primary lateral meristem and secondary lateral meristem. Okay, let's see what is this primary lateral meristem and secondary lateral meristem. Primary means origin is primary. Lateral means position is lateral in position. So, origin is primary means it is formed, it is present from the beginning of plant life. So, it is primary in origin, lateral in position. Okay. So, the only primary lateral meristem is intrafascicular vascular cambium. Intrafascicular vascular cambium present in dicot stem and the stem of gymnosperms. And it is absent in roots of both dicots, gymnosperms and even in monocots. And it is absent in the roots of roots and stems of monocots, right? So the only primary lateral meristem is intrafascicular vascular cambium, also called as fascicular cambium. Also called as fascicular cambium. Let's see where it is present. Fascicular cambium, right? So let's see where it is present. It is present in between xylem and phloem of the vascular bundle, of a vascular bundle. It is present inside the same vascular bundle, but in between phloem and xylem. So it is present between xylem and phloem of a vascular bundle. Of a vascular bundle. Okay, so I am making the diagram of the transverse section of dicot stem to locate the position of this intrafascicular vascular cambium. So let's say this is the transverse section of dicot stem. So this is the transverse section of dicot stem or the stem of gymnosperm, and in this transverse section vascular bundles are arranged in the form of ring. Okay, right. So these are the vascular bundles which are present in the dicot stem and in the stem of gymnosperm. So here, what is this? This is primary phloem. This is primary phloem and this is primary xylem. Xylem which is present towards the center, and this one which is present at the center, that is in between primary phloem and primary xylem, is intrafascicular vascular cambium, which is primary in origin because it is present in the plant from the beginning of life. So this is about intrafascicular vascular cambium. So though it is primary, it is secondary in function because it is involved in the formation of secondary permanent tissues like secondary xylem and secondary phloem. So it is primary in origin. So I am writing here, it is primary in origin, intrafascicular vascular cambium, but it is secondary in function. secondary in function. What is that? Intrafascicular vascular cambium. Right. Now let's study about lateral meristem, secondary lateral meristem. Secondary lateral meristem is nothing. Lateral means it is present towards the lateral side. Secondary means it is formed during the development of plant, that is during secondary growth. Hence it is called secondary. Secondary in origin but lateral in position. So it is secondary lateral meristem. Examples of secondary lateral meristems are interfascicular vascular cambium, interfascicular vascular cambium present in stem of dicots and gymnosperms. Next coming to cock cambium present in both stem and root. Then vascular cambium, which is formed in dicot root and in the roots of gymnosperms. Roots of dicots and gymnosperms, because only dicots and gymnosperms show secondary growth. Next coming to oncambium. So these are different examples of secondary lateral meristems. So among all these secondary lateral meristems, I am going to explain about this interfascicular vascular cambium and about all these remaining lateral meristems, secondary lateral meristems. We will study in the forthcoming part of this chapter. Okay. So here, interfascicular vascular cambium. Interfascicular vascular cambium is present. It is present between vascular bundles. Okay, so these are the vascular bundles. This is one vascular bundle. This is one vascular bundle. Like this, these are the vascular bundles which are arranged in the form of ring. So in between these vascular bundles, interfascicular vascular cambium is formed during the secondary growth, that is in the later stages of plant. So it is secondary in origin. It is not present in the plant body from the beginning. It is formed during the secondary growth. Hence it is secondary in origin, but it is lateral in position, which is said to be secondary lateral meristem. Okay, so the vascular cambium which is formed in between vascular bundles is called as inter, and the cambium which is present in between the xylem and phloem of the same vascular bundle is called as intrafascicular vascular cambium. So now let's see how this interfascicular vascular cambium is formed between the vascular bundles. We are saying that it is secondary in origin. How? Okay. So in between the vascular bundles, primary permanent tissues called medullary rays are present. Primary permanent tissues called medullary rays are present. These medullary rays undergo dedifferentiation. Dedifferentiation is nothing but regaining the capacity of cell division. So the cells present in medullary rays undergo dedifferentiation or regaining the capacity of cell division. So they regain the capacity to divide, capacity of cell division, and get dedifferentiated into secondary meristem. What is that secondary meristem now? That is intrafascicular vascular cambium. So intrafascicular vascular cambium is a secondary lateral meristem which is formed from primary permanent tissue, that is medullary rays, by the process of dedifferentiation, that is by regaining the capacity of cell division. Okay, now after formation of this interfascicular cambium like this, both interfascicular cambium and intrafascicular cambium are joined together to form a complete ring of vascular cambium. So now this is interfascicular vascular cambium. Interfascicular vascular cambium, right? So both of them join together to form vascular cambium. So intra and inter together, resulting in the formation of vascular cambium. So now this vascular cambium, what can we say vascular cambium of dicot stem and gymnosperm is partly primary in origin and partly secondary in origin. What is primary in origin? Primary in origin is intrafascicular vascular cambium. Secondary in origin is interfascicular vascular cambium. So the vascular cambium formed inside the dicot stem and in the stems of gymnosperms is partly primary and partly secondary in origin, but completely secondary in function, because together it results in the formation of vascular cambium, which undergo cell division to form more number of cells, which cut off cells towards outer side and even towards inner side. The cells which cut off towards outer side develop into, that means they undergo redifferentiation, that means again they lose the capacity of cell division and get matured into secondary permanent tissue. Okay, so secondary permanent tissue called phloem towards outer side, and towards inner side secondary permanent tissue called secondary xylem is formed. Secondary xylem is formed. So I just repeat. So vascular cambium is both primary and secondary in origin. Primary in origin because intrafascicular vascular cambium is primary. Interfascicular vascular cambium is secondary in origin. But together, they are together secondary in function, because they are involved in the formation of secondary permanent tissues called secondary phloem towards outer side and secondary xylem towards inner side. So what would be the result of this formation of this secondary permanent tissues? So this vascular cambium is involved in increasing the girth or increasing the diameter of plant organ, that is dicot stem and stem of gymnosperm. So the secondary meristems are involved in increasing the girth or diameter of plant organs, and even intrafascicular vascular cambium is also involved in increasing the girth. That is nothing but secondary growth of plants. It is involved in secondary growth of plants. So this is all about meristems. We studied about the characteristic features of meristems, and then we studied about primary meristem and secondary meristem on the basis of origin, and then we studied about different types of meristem on the basis of location, that is apical meristems, intercalary meristems and lateral meristems, which are two types, that is primary lateral meristem and secondary lateral meristem on the basis of origin again. So in the next video I'll be starting with the shoot apex organization and root apex organization. Hope you understood this concept. Thank you, students.